Right. Look at today's session. So today's session, we are going to understand how to invoke Apex class within the Lightly. Invoking server side controller on from the client side controller. Now look at this. How the basic flow will be there? We had a component. On the component, whenever the event occurs, then it goes to client side controller. On the component, whenever the event occurs, it goes to the client side controller. It goes to the client side controller, and the client side controller, if it want to interact with the server, it goes to the server side controller. Client side controller, if you want any action to be performed, it goes to server side. Now what is the flow? From component, straight away we cannot call server side controller. So on the component, when an event occurs, client side controller is called. Client side controller is going to call server side controller. Again, I repeat, from the component, straight away we cannot call server side controller. Then on the component, when an event occurs, it goes to the client side controller. Client side controller will be calling the server side controller. Next, any call that is going from the client side controller, which is a JavaScript, and the server side controller is Apex class. If a client side controller is calling the server side controller, it has to run like asynchronous operation. Every operation is a asynchronous operation. Now what this client side controller will be doing, every call you are making, immediately it will not go to server side. It will collect all the calls the people are making, collect them, at a time it's sent to the server. It's not like client to client requested, sent to server, client requested, sent to server. Now what it does, I am a queue. Now all the clients who are requesting the server side controllers, collect them at that moment. Put them in a queue. At a time invoke the server operation. So that it will reduce the number of server calls. So every call that is going from client side controller to the server side controller is asynchronous call. Every call that is going from client side controller to server side controller is asynchronous call. Now, if you remember, did you encounter anywhere NQ job? Where did you use the method called NQ job? Where did you use, we have used a functionality called NQ job. Where did we use this? Queueable Apex. When you are going for a queueable Apex, you have called. Why? You want that operation to run like a asynchronous. We are putting that action to the queue. We are running them in asynchronous format. Same concept. Same NQ concept should be used in the JavaScript. So from the JavaScript, whenever server side controller is called, from JavaScript, whenever server side controller is called, it has to be enqueued first. It has to be enqueued first. I hope you are good. Okay. So let us get into the critical part of the story. First, can I call every Apex class in the Lightning? Is the first question. Can I call every Apex class in the Lightning? Is the first question. So what is our concept here? Right. So if you want to invoke Apex class within the Lightning, we need to understand at the rate of your name. Now, what are the annotations we have seen in the classic? Tell me. At the rate of feature, at the rate of okay, at the rate of is test. Then we have seen what are the other annotations we have seen in the invocable. At the rate of invocable, we invoke an apex class within the process builder. At the rate of REST resource in the integration, at the rate of HTTP post, at the rate of HTTP get, at the rate of source. So we have seen some of the annotation. Similarly, we have one new annotation which is called at the rate of URI. If you want any Apex class to be invoked in the Lightning, or if you want any variable of the Apex class to be invoked in the Lightning, listen to the term. If you want, first you go and sit at other place. Right. Now, what we are doing here? At the rate of URI. So, if you want any Apex class to be used within the Lightning, or if you want a variable of the class, if you want a variable of the class to be used in the Lightning, then we go for at the rate of URI enabled. So, at the rate of URI enabled is a annotation which is used to enable the class to be enable the class to be invoked from client side controller. If you want a client side controller to call a server side controller, if a client side controller want to have an access to the server side Apex class, then that Apex class has to be defined as at the rate of URI enabled. I hope you are good. If a client side controller want to access the server side controller class, that class has to be defined as at the rate of URI enabled. Is that was clear for everyone? Okay. Now, are you going to create the class as at the rate of URI enabled? It is not the class we create at the rate of URI enabled. It is a method in the class which we create. So, if you want methods from the server side controller to be invoked in the client side controller, the method has to have at the rate of URI enabled. It is not the class. The methods in the class has to be at the rate of URI enabled. Okay. Now, once again, is it a class or a method? Is it a class or a method which is enabled? It is a methods which are enabled. Okay. Now the next point is how many methods we can create? How many methods we can create? N number of methods we can create. There is no problem. Why did we insist this point? I told only you can write N number of URI enabled method. Why did I insist this point? Do you remember, if you are giving at the rate of invocable method, there can be only one method. A class can have only one invocable method. If you are using an annotation called at the rate of invocable, it can have only one method with invocable method. There is no other methods. There is a reason I specified here. You can have n number of methods in the class with the annotation at the rate of URI enabled. Again, I mentioned, is it the class which have an annotation or the methods in the class? Now, any class which contains a method with at the rate of URI enabled, they can be invoked from the client side controller. Okay. Now, if you are trying to invoke a variable of the Apex class, that also should have at the rate of URI enabled. That means methods of the class or the variables of the class, if you want to invoke from the client side controller, they should have an annotation called at the rate of URI enabled. There is a point here. Now, next, let us look at the format. If you are going for the URI enabled, I need to understand. What was that? The method should be at the rate of URI enabled. Now, when you are giving a Lightning component, it will obey user context. Lightning component will obey user context. When I am using a term called user context, what do you mean by that? According to the user sharing rule, whatever is visible, whatever is accessible, that will be displayed in the component. Now tell me, is the visual force is a user context or the system context? Visual force is always a user context. If you are not writing any controller, without writing any controller, without writing any controller, Visual Force page with a standard controller equal to account, if you take as per your profile, as per your sharing rule, whatever is visible, only that data will be coming. When I use a controller, Apex class, by default it is a system context. Whatever the logic we wrote in the Apex class, that you are putting in a variable and displaying. That is the reason everything is getting displayed. Now when I say system context or user context, user context means without writing any custom logic, without writing any server side logic, straight away existing functionalities if you are trying to use, or existing objects you are trying to use, or existing fields you are trying to use, or existing data you are trying to use, that will run as per the user context. Visual Force is 100% user context when it is not taking the data from controller. Now from controller, straight away we are not taking. What we are doing? Creating a variables. Variables doesn't have any user context or system context. Right? Variables doesn't have any user context or system context. Every variable I can define. But when you're referring to the data from an object, straight away standard controller equal to account, account dot name, account dot phone, account dot industry, then if you have that permission, you will be able to see. If you don't have the permission, you will not be able to see. Or else, if you are giving a standard controller equal to account and you are giving a standard actions like save, edit, delete, okay, cancel, this again as per your profile on this object, what permissions you have, as per that only actions will run. So pure Visual Force page is user context. Similarly, Lightning component is also user context. Pure Visual Force without server side controller is user context. When you go to server side controller, you are deciding whether you want to run like a user context or a system context with the help of a keyword call, with a sharing or without sharing. Are you getting my point? Pure Visual Force page is a user context. Pure Lightning component is a user context. When I write a server side controller, there we have an option to decide whether you want to run like a user context or a system context with the help of a keyword call, with sharing and without sharing. If you don't define anything, by default it is considering as without sharing. That's how programs are running on the context of a system. Now, the next, when the class is running in the context of a system, what does it mean? Now, Apex class is running in the context of system means not the variables, the DML operations, SQL queries, what you perform, they are running in system context or user context. When I use a word call, system context, the DML operations, SQL queries, what you are running, they are running as per the system context or user context. Variable is our choice. Now Salesforce has nothing to do because I created my own variable. Now Salesforce doesn't have a control on it. But the SQL query, retrieving the data from database, if OWD is private, you can only get your data. If OWD is public read, we can get only read access on the data. So DMLs and SQLs written in the Apex class will be running as per the context. What is their context? System or user. If you don't define, they are system. I hope you are good. Now, when you are writing a server-side controller, even in the Lightning, Lightning component is a user context. Now, when you are writing a server-side controller, it is asking you whether it is a user context or a system context. Because when I am writing a SQL query, let us take a quick example. This guy wrote a SQL query. When he wrote a SQL query, should I give all the records or should I give only your records? Should I give only your records? Then I have to decide. If I want all the records, program has to run in the context of system. If I want only my records, program has to run with the user context. If you are defining with the user context, these classes should be added, pages should be added separately to the profile. If any classes defined with the sharing context, they will not be visible to the profile by default. All the profiles will not get access to these pages or classes. most of the time you got a habit of writing a without sharing. Very probably one or two contexts only we are given with the sharing while explaining the concept. But if you define a class as a with sharing, they are not visible to every profile. You have to manually go to every profile, enable the option called add them. Look at this example I got here. If I go to system admin profile, enable visual force pages, right? Enable Apex classes. So what was this? This person is able to see everything. Now by default, if I give with sharing, they will not be added to every profile. I have to go there, click on edit, select the page and class to this profile. Then only this profile will be able to see. So you decide whether the class is a with sharing or without sharing as per your business requirement. Are you clear about this? Are you clear about this? Right. Now, right. Okay. Now, every method you defined with the era enable annotation, we know by default it is a static method. Wherever we have used annotation call at the rate of for a method, everywhere it is static. Then it can have return type, it can have parameter. It can have return type, it can have parameter. But when you take a line, when you take your visual force page, if you are trying to invoke a method from Apex class, it will have only void or a page reference. Any method we are invoking from a Apex class within the Lightning can have any return type, any parameter. But if you are trying to invoke a method from Apex class within the Visual Force page, from the Visual Force page, when I click on a button, some method I am calling. What is the thumb rule? Method should not contain any parameter. Method should not contain any return type other than void or page reference. Whereas the methods what we are defining for a Lightning can have any return type, any parameters. Any return type, any parameters. I hope you are good with this. So, how you are defining? If you want an Apex class to be invoked in the Lightning, that Apex class should have, okay, at the rate of era enabled elements. That at the rate of era enabled methods and at the rate of era enabled variables. Now, from a class, if you want to invoke a method or a variable in the Lightning, that method should have at the rate of era enabled. And the variable should have at the rate of era enabled. Now, if it is a method, it has to be a static method. It can have any return type. It can have any number of parameters. If it is a variable, at the rate of era enabled, it is a general format. General format. Now, I hope you are good with this. Right. Then, let us go to the next one. We'll see how it can be given here. Now when you're giving, if you want to throw any exceptions, if you want to throw any exception, you can define your own exceptions here. You can define your own exceptions. Okay. It's too early to discuss the point. Okay. Come back. So let us go to the operation. When you are invoking this, client side controller is invoking it. Okay. So how this client side controller is going to invoke, we'll see one by one. First, let us create an Apex class. How are you creating an Apex class? Draw example one. Draw enable. Public static. Very, very basic example. Very, very basic level example. It doesn't make any difference here. If you want this Lightning functionality to be used outside the package, then you define them as a global. Within the organization, it's okay. Because we are going to pack. Lightning components will not be deployed. They will be given like a packages. If I want to give this, write the package, deliver this package to the production. Right? Okay. Now look at this. At the rate of era enabled. This is the class what I created. Let us take the first one. If a client side controller want to invoke the methods or members from the Apex class, then methods and any method which is just at the rate of URI enabled can be invoked the client side controller any variable which is annotated can be accessed from steps to define every method in the server side controller method should have static method can be method can have method can have run type and parameters. At the rate of URI enabled I'm writing a query. This is how we're writing. So if you want to define a variables, if you want to define, want to access any variable, it's not necessary that you have to use get and set. You can leave that, no issue, because we are not accessing from VF. We are accessing from client set. Not necessary that you have to give get and set. This we can define it. This is how we defined Apex class. So overall example. This is how I created your example. I guess everyone is good with this concept till here, right? Okay. Let us come back to the component side, writing component with your client side controller. Now, how to invoke this Apex class? Lightning component. What should I do? If you want to invoke, you want to access any Apex class, if you want to access any Apex class in the Lightning, if you want to access any Apex class in the Lightning, so we are different. Euro component controller equal to example. Euro component controller equal to example. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Next. We cannot call now. Look at the format. We cannot call server side controller. We cannot call server side controller directly from Lightning. So when the event occurs on the component, when the event occurs on the component, this will call client side controller. Client side controller will be calling server side controller. Now, from the Lightning component, we cannot straight away call server side method. So when an event occurs, client side control is called, client side control is called, client side control is calling the server side controller. Now if you want to call a server side controller, now invoking lightning, invoking invoking server side controller from client side controller. How do you invoke server side controller from the client side controller? Now we are going to keep first component dot get c dot now what is this component from which this event fired, that component controllers that is referred C dot. So the component from where event is fired, that component server side controllers method. So it is a component dot get c dot method name. Component dot get c dot method name. This is how we are going to define it. Then if you want to invoke, if you want to invoke it, if you want to set, look at the format. If you want to pass the parameters, server side controller, how will you pass it? Look at the format. It should be passed as set params this should be passed. If you want to pass any parameters to the server side controller, it should be passed in the form of map. This should be passed. So what I'm doing here, equal to component dot get c dot, then we need to say action dot set params this should be passed, setting the parameters. So whatever the method we are calling, that method instance is an action. This is a variable boss. I can give A or B or C, it's my choice. Then A dot set params. Then third step, create a callback action. So after invoking that method and passing, it is going to give you some result. Whatever the result they are giving, with the result what you want to perform, what is the logic you want to perform. When you made a call to them, they are going to run the logic, going to give you some result back. The result what they are giving, with the result what is the action you want to perform. Now you made a request, they are sending a response. How to handle the response what they have sent? When I made a request to the server side, they have made an action giving the response to you. Whatever the response they have given, with the response, what is the action we are performing? So create a callback action. How will you create? Set this comma, set callback, this function response. Parameter 1, please. Parameter 1 is always this. This is referring second parameter. Callback. This will specify what is the action. This way, how the response is handled. How to handle the action. So, how it is defined? Function set callback, we are going to get function response. So, get the state of the response. Using what? Get state. When you say get state, this will return state of the operation. What are the possible states? Look at the possible states, the group of states here. New, running, success, error, incomplete, aborted. This is done. Next we have get. This will return the value written by the server side. So when you call a method, the method is giving some return type, right? So when I say show, it is giving a return type, get a string show, it is giving a string value. List of account, it is giving a list of accounts, list of contacts, list of wrapper class. Whatever the value that method is giving, that value is taken by get return type. So basically, set callback, it is used to handle the response what we received. Whether response is success or failure, we need to know. Second one, what is the value that response is giving? With that value, what is the action you want to do? If that server is giving a response, from the response take the value. With that value, what do you want to do? Everything is defined in a set callback. So overall, how it is defined here? Look at this. anything you can give. Component dot get. ABC dot set. Some data I'm giving. Then I'm giving. Set callback. This function callback. Within the response function I'm giving here. What do you want to do? Where state equal to state equal to success. I want to get the value what you have given, where result equal to response dot. This is the functionality. Component dot get the method name, set the parameters, callback, check whether status is success or not. If it is success, do this operation. Are you getting my point here? Right, boss? Component dot get C dot method name. If you want to set the parameter, you can set the parameters. If you want to check whether response is success or failure, response dot get state. If you want to get the value what the method is giving, response dot get return value. Okay. Then last step. Enqueue action. Any method call, any call to the server side, will be asynchronous call. To run this call, run this operation as asynchronous. Add it to queue. Dollar A dot. Dollar A dot enqueue action. This is a quick theoretical information about the process what we are trying to follow. I feel everyone has followed. I feel that everyone has followed these steps what I explained. I hope everyone has followed this. Steps. People have followed this. Okay. Now let us go to one example. This is the class what I created. When this is the class, let me create a lightning component. Where I am giving controller equal to. Your example. Gonna have I'm just printing the message. Basic example. Then click on controller. What is the method in this? Then what you are supposed to do? Where? You can do anything. ABCR is a variable. Component dot get C dot. What is the C dot call me? Call me is a method from. The method doesn't have any parameters right now. First dollar a dot we are adding the action to the in between whatever you want to do you can perform it. What was that? ABC dot set this comma function then I'm giving var state equal to if state if state equal to success then we want to get the response result equal to response dot then what I want to do this response I want to keep it to this attribute how do you keep it to attribute component dot set this is how I create. Anyone has any query on this functionality now? Look at the code. The state is success. Comparison with enum value. Comparison with enum value. Here is as a fixed value. The fixed action value we are supposed to go with triple equal. These are the states of action, so we are supposed to use triple equal. Done. Right, boss. So once you got the value, what we have printed, then get the return value, then set it to the component. I hope everyone is good with this, right? Now we are supposed to execute this. How will you execute this? Lightning application. force now. Bug, go back, inspect console. I'm invoked from Apex class. You got the result. So result is coming properly, but setting has failed. Why the setting has failed? V dot, what was this name? Result V dot var. Okay, go back again. This one I'm invoked from Apex class. Right boss, a basic quick example. The next example, everyone has followed this? So let us say, let us look at the next example. How to pass the attributes? How to pass the parameter? Now, how we are going to pass a parameter to the server side controller? If you want to pass a parameter, already I told you, set params. What was that? Set params. Okay. Now, let us go to the next example here. Let me put this example. For example one. Once I put the code into the GitHub, I'll give an access on the code. Right now I will not give an access on the codes, only VF, so that nobody can modify. So lightning component. I hope everyone has followed this example, right boss? This is the first example we are seeing. Let us go to the second example. Right. So let us go to the second scenario. What was our second scenario? Invoking or passing a parameter to the Apex class. So how do you pass the parameter? So we are giving here let us go with the basic examples. very, very basic level, but a method with parameters. Right, boss? Then we are giving then what I want to do is input. Just trying to use the previous components what we learned. Just trying to apply the previous components what we have seen. I'll give field, I cannot use it. I have to give UI output text I can give. But the problem is if I give UI, the CSS will not be applied on this. No issue. So UI output text value. So I have given this. Chalo. What I was supposed to do? Let's go with extends. Force SLDS example 2. Now we had L name value equal to EMP name. Why do we have this headache, boss? UI is not supported. Come again. I give the same IDs. Okay. Why you require a controller? We are just trying to display. We are just trying to display functionality. When you click on this, the control is there or not is verified. Some typo error somewhere. Check out any typo error. Come again, Amma. If you don't give anything, by default it is what? Text. Okay. The bug was from alter. Fine, the issue was with the button here. Chalo, let me not prolong it much. Let us check with them because the topic was not that. We are deviating from the issue. Now we have given this. Go to the controller. In the controller, what is the functionality I gave? First, we are supposed to read the value of the component where L. Component dot find. Why find? As you are trying to get the value based on. Component dot find. Then where action equal to component dot get. What is the name of the class? What is the method? C dot get. Then always enqueue it. Enqueue the action. Now give the callback functionality. Before we give the callback functionality, action dot set errors. Whatever the names we give, exactly the same name should be given. In the same order. Whatever the names we give here, exact name should be given, otherwise it throws an error. This is how we are passing. After passing the data, invoke the callback. Action dot set. Action dot set callback. This function then first you are supposed to check where state equal to if state equal to success where get return value. Then I am giving component dot set v dot emp name team. This is the functionality what I have built. So go back here. This is how we are getting the data called your name, right boss? So what I am doing, passing the parameters. What did I do in this case? I created a component. This component we had label enter and also give default value. Now this is what I have given. First I am taking the value. When I click on this, I am going for an invoke method. When I click on this, I am going for an invoke method. Right. Srivastava, meet your mic. Srivastava, meet your mic. Right. So then when I click on invoke, what I'm doing? When you click on the invoke, then we are going for client side controller where we had find out the value of last name and first name, then set the action. So what is the first format we have done? Read the value of first name and last name, then invoke the then pass the parameters. Then define callback action. I hope everyone has followed this example. Good with this example? Shall we try one example? Right. I'll give a use case, start building this example. Now, let us try out one example. I'll just give a basic use case. Just for practice, no working interest. then define an apex class. Example with a class. This will calculate. This is a method. This is going to return you interest. So complete this example. So era enabled. The method is public static decimal calculate. Or you want to take integer value, I'll just go with integer. Integer amount. Still, we didn't touch any S objects. We didn't refer S objects either in the component or in the server side. Only with the primitives we are doing as of now. Then define the component. Lightning. Then we're going with this is what we have created. What was that? See, control will come if I call it. We don't call, control will not come. It's a component with the lighting inputs, right? Did I use any attributes here? Did I use any actions here? No such type of things, right? Then how can the control will come? This is what I have given. Then first let us check it out whether application UI is coming properly or not. I was supposed to apply some CSS also. Same story. but width and height will increase. I guess 400 will be sufficient. So go to application, have a preview. Oops. Now what was the bug here? So we not applied. So we go to the structure. This is what I received. Right. So I want to calculate. Then what is the immediate action? The controller, what is the read the value. How do you read the value? Component dot get. So we got it. Then we are supposed to invoke the method where action. Then we are giving where action component dot get. Action dot set. Then we have, what is the parameter they are expecting here? Amount, rate, year. I told you already, exact name should be there. Then I'm giving action dot set callback. So we are supposed to use this. Is it necessary that I always have to write a response only? Not necessary. It is also a variable. Whatever you want to use, you can use it. Steady equal to success, then we are going to give. Component dot find What is the element I gave here? ID is you want to give a console.log to check out, you can give it. This is how we create. And go back to the next one. Application. What was that? Unable to find invoke. Maybe C dot invoke. Issue with the invoke. Where is the component? C dot invoke. First component on click C dot invoke. Invoke. What we got here? Why unable to find invoke method? Pardon me. Same comment. Example 3 component. Did I create the component for what? I have given the component for application, not for the component. This is the bug. I was supposed to go to this component. Oh, CSS also created there only. Instead of creating the component for the controller for the component, I have created for application. Now, then go back and see what is the issue here. No, there is an error. We got an error. So study is not successful. Why the study is not successful? Why the study is not successful? So let us print. Check out whether I have given a proper call for the method. Amount, rate, year. Amount, rate, yes. Now, method invocation failed. Exactly. I guess I have not given. Yeah, you have given this. So, the problem may be with this, if I am right. This. Let me check out one more time, run the view. So what was that? 1000. We are getting the values. So action dot get action dot set. Where was that? Line number set parameter set. So this bug is because of what, boss? It doesn't have a compiler. If you same thing, if you implement in the Visual Force array. Apex program, if semicolon is not there, what it will do? It will slap you and say semicolon is missing, put it out. But when you go to the Lightning, it's not a compiler, it's a interpreted. So only when you're running the program, check one by one. Still it's not fixed up. Because we're converting the values into integer, I guess there's some bug with respect to that. So what I will do, go to Apex class. Okay, let me go back and cross check once again. So let me go to the developer console and see what may be the issue. Buggy is coming as. Rate integer false. Internal salesforce.com error. Look at the point. Amount 1000 is coming. Integer 2 is coming. So there's a bug with the calculation here. So when this error, it is not even printing of operation. Method invoked. So from here the mistakes are coming. What's the mistake here? Decimal interest, amount, rate, years by, 100, then interest. Is it a mistake from our end or from system end? Because they are giving us internal error. Let us check it out. Go back to the application again. Functionality is invoked. From that, response is not coming. Now, go back to the log file. What is the bug we have received here? Method invoked, then 5005 internal error. So the values are also getting displayed 5005. So till here everything is coming fine. So some problem with this. Where was our Apex class, Amma? Right. So where is our Apex class? So till here we are getting fine. Interest, this is not printed, right? Now look at this. If you look at the example, method invoked, debug 5000, debug 5, debug 5, then the calculation is not happening. Now what may be the error for the calculation? Come again. Right. What do you mean by type caching and type conversion? Type conversion, are you going to do the type conversion our system will do? Small value can be stored to the larger value if there is any issue. But larger value, if you are trying to store to the smaller value, there is a issue. So, chalo, let us give. Go back again. So simple calculation is throwing error. 5,000, 5, 5. So error is with respect to. So let us go to the JavaScript. Now look at this. There was some bug that is happening between the calculation, whatever you have given the braces. So the rest of the things are coming perfectly in the Apex class also. Mother invoked 5,055 internal salesforce.com error. So the error is occurring here. So let me make it amount. This calculation is throwing error message. What was this? It is expecting. Run it. So go for a preview. Let me give without a calculation, boss. From the code side, there is no error. There is no error from the code side. There is a basic calculation, right? There is a basic calculation. Right. So some error with the calculation was right. So we have given basic calculation A into B into C I have given. Nothing more than that, right? So let me check. There may be some reason for it. There may be some internal reason for it. Okay. I'll track it out and let you know. Okay. So that's all.